Hello everyone. Today we'll be talking about the fears faced by mental health professionals. As a mental health professional myself, I can tell you that this is a very sensitive and field full of empathy and compassion. While we have to be empathetic and compassionate with our clients, at the same time we have to keep on updating our knowledge, enhancing our skills, and at the same time remaining ethically very sound. So in all this journey, we also have to navigate our lives with our families, colleagues, friends. So let's see how our mental health friends, mental health professional friends deal with their lives in this journey.
I think I fear most thinking about a moment where I'll be unable to think freely. So that freedom of thought and allowing my mind to soar high in the sky or deep into thought is my prerogative, my freedom, and anything which binds that, it troubles. That is the fear which I have. Although it has never come true, and it will not, as long as the mind and brain keeps working.
To be honest, the list is long. It ranges from the so-called trivial things to the more serious ones. But the one fear that I would want to talk about is the fear of death. Death and dying. I know it's a heavy topic, but it is what it is.
One of the things that comes to my mind immediately is a fear of whether I can do justice to the emotional needs of my family while constantly trying to deal with emotional challenges in the clinical setting as well as trying to deal with my own. So I think in order to make sure that I hit the balance right, I do a few things. One is doing yoga regularly, doing pranayam regularly, and also self-reflection, giving myself some time to reflect on what's happening within me. And I also seek supervision and therapy whenever needed so that I can do justice to my clients as well as my home members. Spending time with the family is always something very relaxing, and doing that makes me feel good. So
my biggest fear is fear of being criticized or hurt. And this fear pushes me to put a lot of pressure on myself to be perfect, and it can get quite stressful sometimes. It took a long time for me to understand about this fear.
One of my predominant fears is that of public speaking, and the thoughts that invade my mind are that what if I make a mess of things? What if people laugh at me? And these result in a lot of anxiety.
Earlier it was more about what if I die? How long do I have on this planet, right? How do I accomplish everything that I want to do in such a short span of time? How do I read all the books that I want to read? How do I travel to all the places that I want to go with the limited time that I get? But as I have grown up, the fear has also sort of become about what happens if people around me and people that I love especially, they die. What happens then? How will I survive the loss? And will they survive the loss if I die? How will they cope? How will I cope with that loss? In what ways will it change them? In what ways will it change me? So these are the questions that still keep coming back to me. They still haunt me.
The general theme is danger to myself or my family. It could be a disaster like an earthquake or a fire, or it could be trapped in the house, or a burglar. You know, different kinds of fears can arise, and in that moment they seem the worst.
There's one more fear that I constantly face is whether my work might become irrelevant because I'm in a small city and there's not much opportunity to get updated as we don't have many mental health activities happening in the city and we do not have many professional groups. So in order to kind of deal with that stress, I make it a point to be attending different conferences, workshops at a national level whenever I can. And I also keep reading and keep a part of the WhatsApp groups and maybe Gmail platforms that can provide such a base for self-development and knowledge and growth.
One of the ways I've learned to cope with these things is to treat these thoughts as visitors and not to believe in these thoughts, so I don't cling on to these thoughts.
One thing that definitely helped to get over it was therapy. And surprisingly, the fear itself has helped in a way. When I make my decisions now, I'm making on what my goals are, what I want, rather than what is expected of me. I'm taking time out to engage in activities and things that give me a feeling of joy that makes me feel peaceful, right? I'm also learning to let go of things or the need to control everything. Does it always work? No, it doesn't. But I do have to try.
So what do I do about those fears? Definitely use my cognitive behavior therapy skills. And the simple thing to do is thought, feeling, and action. What is the fear thought? How am I feeling in connection with the fear thought? And develop an adaptive action plan. I definitely use that for disaster planning. I use that to stay safe at home. I've used that to prepare for the pandemic. And pretty much any kind of fear, which may seem like the worst in the moment.
I started coping by being less harsh on myself. I realized that with the fear of criticism, I was putting a lot of pressure on myself and in turn being more self-critical. I realized by sort of picking up on triggers where I was pushing myself very hard. Instead, I would sort of take a break, take care of myself, be a little more kind and compassionate towards self. It also helped me to accept my limitations and thereby accepting myself. So I'm still working on it. It is always a process to cope. And this has helped me to a certain extent to, you know, sort of deal with the stress and manage and feel better.
So instead of planning for the whole next year, I'm planning for tomorrow, or I'm maybe planning for next week at the stretch. Trying to focus on what I have is something that I have to remind myself to keep doing. When the fear grips me, and sometimes it does, especially in the last 1 year, one thing that I do is I reach out to someone. Usually it is my brother, because he's around, we live in the same house. And I tend to hold his hand while things sort of calm down inside my head. The distraction, or rather engaging in a sense, in this case the tactile sense, helps me make sure that it is not spiraling. Along with this circular breathing and some grounding exercises, that also help to an extent. But I think therapy was the best thing that ever happened.
I cope with it in a different way. Over time, I have learned to differentiate between the irrelevant and the relevant. So, this is a lot of information bombardment from outside. So the mind has learned how to filter that, what not to get affected with. And obviously the mind has learned that all this is a passing phase and there'll always be a next moment. And of course, if you can't travel in body, your body may be stuck in the grind, but mind can travel fine. So as long as I can go into the world of imagination, that's enough for me. And that takes out the fear too.
I'm sure this video was interesting for all of you. In this particular video, I really commend my mental health professional friends who have spoken about their vulnerabilities and stress so openly and directly. It is really very difficult, let me tell you that. Besides that, you can see that a lot of them have been able to look inside themselves and look at different angles of the same problem. Like Dr. Alok says, he has also been able to look at larger life issues with a very simple and practical perspective. I think this is the beauty of this particular profession, and I'm sure you all would appreciate it. I would also say that just as everyone else, mental health professionals are also very human, as you can see from this video. And whenever it is not possible for us to use our techniques that we have learned, we do reach out to another mental health professional for help. Thank you so much.